Welcome to Today I Work On. Let's talk about 8-inch spread faucets. This is a Kohler 8-inch spread. It's the Avail. I just got back from vacation. I'd rather be hunting for cruising ducks right now, but that's not the case. We're installing faucets, because that's life. We have an 8-inch spread here. This is for an 8-inch spread. You're gonna see on the box, this is 8-inch white spread bath and faucet. Do not buy a 4-inch spread. 4-inch spread on an 8-inch spread is not gonna work, vice versa, keep that in mind. So this is the Kohler unit. It's a really nice unit. So let's open up the box and see what we got. Ooh, the water looks nice on this box. All right, we have directions. We have, right off the bat, I guarantee you this is the connection for to put all the units together. This is the drain. It's a plastic drain. It's a pop-up drain and it says Kohler on it. I'm not loving the plastic. I'd rather have metal. This right here is the main center piece where the water comes out of. Let's take a look at this. It looks nice. This is, I'm assuming, I don't know yet because it doesn't see anything. Same thing, let's take off this rubber band. Okay, that's done. Make sure that the plastic does not get stuck in there. And then we have the other side, and oh, it says cold. So make sure where it says cold or hot, depending on the manufacturer, you put it on the right side. And then lastly, we have two plastic bags. This looks like it's for the main faucet, and this one looks like it's for the actual handles. So let's open these up and see what we got going on. Let's open up this bag first. Use my teeth, one of my most important tools. And we have, this is a little tool to get rid of the aerator on the faucet right here, because before you can turn the water on, you should pop this off and we should run water through. So it's actually easier to take this off now than later. So I'm gonna take this off now. And you can see, it's a little funky to get in there, but you can see there's little teeth and they just go like so. Make sure you don't lose any of the washers. See, this is popping out and leave it just like that. You don't want to mess with it. So we'll put this right here. That is the first step. Well, this is the screw that goes on to here. That tightens it up. You turn it this way, just like so. And then this is a washer that goes on first. This goes against the countertop material. And then this metal ring goes on next. That's that. All right, let's work on the actual faucet handles. Faucet handles, let's open this up. Use my teeth again, because why not? If it's more than plastic, I don't use my teeth, I use an actual tool. We have screws. I'm assuming the screws will go into here, like so. One, two. And then we have the same thing, we have two of each. So we have a metal ring and we have a rubber ring, same thing. It'll go up like this. This will be the countertop material. And then we have this ring right here. So that's basically it. Nothing else comes in the Kohler box. Now, ooh, look what we got here. We got the Speedy. My old boss called it a Speedy. It's actually a brass craft connector. That's what you actually call it. I ripped that off. And then that gets connected right here. Boom. We're not going to do that yet, though. We're going to wait to do that. And then I have another one here for the other faucet. So we went through the logistics. Now let's go through how we actually install it on the countertop. The first step, you know, you kind of see these videos where they put this on first and they wiggle it in there. I don't think it really matters, to be honest with you. So I just stick this in here like so, and then I'm going to go underneath now and put this together because I don't think it matters. First, I put this little rubber gasket thingy on, and then I put the metal washer on, and then I start screwing it in. Well, I'm screwed it now. I'm just gonna wiggle it around a little bit and just try to get the center to the drain. And that's right about there. And now I'm gonna tighten it up. That looks pretty good right there. I don't tighten it up until I have these two other faucets in, and you'll see why. Next up, let's put in the cold side. We will just put it in there just like so. And then I'm gonna check. So that's on, off. I'm gonna leave it right there. Try not to move it. Then I'll put the hot in. Same thing. I'm going to check it on, off. And now we're going to go underneath. Now we install the rubber washer first. Get that in there. Next, we install
the metal washer. Now it feels kind of tight, but remember, this is a little flexible, so you could actually get it in pretty easily. Lastly, we're gonna put this little nut on with the screws, and then we're gonna come all the way up. And they make it nice and easy because it has the screws on it. So two hands, and then just start turning, and then just turn until it gets kind of snug, not completely snug. All right, we'll do the same thing on the other side. Done. All right, so now let's go up and check the faucet handles.
So let's check this out. So now you see it's off a little bit, so I'm gonna just go like that. There's a little bit of wiggle room. Don't make it too tight so you can adjust. You just wanna make sure the faucet handles and the spout are in the same line, basically. This looks about right. And now I'll be able to go underneath and tighten it up.
Take a Phillips head screwdriver, like an Ugga. That's one. Let's do two. Nothing too crazy. Lastly, just get a little extra turn on this one nut here. That should be good. Like I said, nothing too tight. This washer, this rubber right here really tightens it up well. So that's the next step. Let's hook up the handles to the actual faucet assembly. So basically you just push like so on that. You want to hear that click. And then the directions say, just bend this line. And then you also click. Same thing for this one. Bend this line. And it clicks. So that's done. That's pretty straightforward. So now we'll put the speedies on. I don't really tighten these up much. Just nice and easy. Nothing crazy. I'm going to take two wrenches. I'm going to tighten this up just a little bit. All right, I tighten that up. Tighten this up right here. Like I said, not too tight. I let the washers do the work. I see people over tighten these all the time. I'm gonna show you how little you have to tighten this up. Not much. No Teflon, no silliness. Let's turn it on. That's it, it's high and dry. We'll do the other side, we'll hook up the waist. I use the channel locks because I don't want the brass to spin, because then you could have a problem because it can break. So you're gonna see, I don't really, same thing up top. I don't tighten it up much. So just about, that's about it. It's not much, you don't want to tighten up too much. Now let's hook it up over here. You have to just feel it out. It's still turning, but now I'm gonna take the wrench to it. I try to hand tighten as much as possible. And then what I usually like to see here, there's a little piece of brass. I like that brass in this part to get tight, but not too tight. Again, it doesn't have to be too tight. Let's turn it on. And that is now on. So now we will hook up the drain. Before I hook up the drain, I shut them off real fast because I don't want to hit the handles by mistake. And then I have a flood. So next step is working on the drain assembly. Right now, just a little bit of mega lock right around the drain. Why? I've been doing this recently. I have not used mega lock for years. Years, years, and years, and I just went with my feel. But I always used to have a little drip here and there. And I was like, you know what? Why don't I just throw some mega lock on the assemblies just so it's safer. It's not a rookie move. It's not being like hacky. It's just you get a better end result. So same thing here, hand tighten. You're not supposed to really do too much of an Ugga here. Just hand tighten, that's about it. Next up, let's get the quarter inch drain. Now what I do is I don't cut anything. I'll stick the initial waistline into the actual PVC, and then I take the P-trap and then I go like so, and I'm like, oh, okay, I need to cut right here. So I'm gonna use a vibrating saw like this and cut. Now I just take a half inch off, not even a quarter inch. That's done. I do a test fit and then I see, okay, it looks pretty good. Now my next step is I cut disassembly, my finger, I come out like so, I'm like, oh, okay, let me add about an inch, give or take, to where my thumb is, and that's where I'm gonna cut it. Done. So now you clean the plastic off, like so, and now we're gonna start putting on all the nuts and the washers. More mega lock. I just do it around where the connection hits, because this actually is the most common leak on these assemblies. So I put it right there, and we put a washer on like so, make sure again this is clean, and then I stick this into the hole. Okay, I don't tighten anything up. Next step, same thing here. I throw some mega lock around the inside of the ring, and then I throw a little bit on the top over here. Not much, like I said, I'm barely spreading it on, but you'd be surprised how much this makes your life easier. And then we're gonna take, we take the nut first, we go up, take the washer, go up, and then I lightly attach this one. Nothing crazy. Next up, same thing. I take a little bit and I just go around the inside. Nothing crazy, super light. Same thing over here. Super light, nothing crazy. Like, I'm barely using anything because you don't really need much. If you need a lot, then your connection is not how it should be. Very, very light. Now, I put, again, the nut on, put the washer on, like so. Bring it up there, looks good. And now let's make the connection. So I'm gonna connect this like here, and then I'm just gonna feel out where this needs to be. I think that's about right. I'm gonna bring down this nut. Don't cross thread it, you could easily cross thread this nut right here. You don't wanna do that. And then what I do is I take the washer and I slide that down first. I tuck it into the channel, and then I put this nut on. I check this nut up top, see what we got there. It looks pretty good. Tighten this nut. Then I hand tighten all these nuts just a little bit. All right, let's turn the water on and let's see what we got going on.
Turn the hold on first. You see it's spitting a little bit, which is fine. Turn on the hot. Looks good. Let's put in the aerator since I clean out the lines. It's kind of annoying, and you need to make sure it's, when you screw it on, it goes full tight because it needs to hit the washer. If it doesn't hit the washer, you're gonna have a weird spray. So keep going, and that's it. It felt good. Let's turn it on. That looks beautiful. It's still spitting a little bit, but it's fine. So now let's see if we have any leaks. We just hit the overflow, so let's take a look at me. Overflow seems like it's doing its job. Remember, the overflow is not gonna stop this from overflowing because the overflow has a way smaller drain than what's the water that's coming out. So it gives you, it buys you some time. Not much time, but some time. You can hear the water is going through the overflow, and that means it's working. I don't see any leaks. So now I'm gonna pop the stop and let's see what happens. It looks nice and dry. Looks good. Let's wrap up this video. Well, isn't that pretty? Nice gold trim. This is the Kohler Avail. These new Kohler faucets are getting easier and easier to install, which is great for DIYers. It's great for contractors. It's great for plumbers. The fit and finish is really nice. The pop-up drain really saves a lot. I totally recommend the pop-up drain. Pulling that little piece in the back to stop water is kind of silly. In 2023, I still install a lot of them, but I definitely prefer pop-ups in my own opinion. So That's a wrap. If you like this video, please like it. If you like my how I install things, please subscribe, because I'm going to have a lot more videos, and I truly appreciate all the support. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you next time.